The fourth street of Gawalmandi is one of the most iconic places of Punjab and one of the most famous places to visit in Lahore. It's known as one of the best places to eat in the city and offers a large variety of different types of food, ranging from a different menu for each time of the day, whether it's the early morning, the afternoon, or the night. There's always something to find there. The word Gawal means someone who sells milk and Mandi means market. The name is based on the fact it was one of the largest buffalo milk producing markets of Punjab until 1947, when a lot of Kashmiris started settling into the place and brought over their cultural food, such as the harissa, while the Sikhs brought over their own amazing fish recipes, being known as the Sardar fish. I couldn't go there for the early morning, so that's gonna be for another day. When I did go there, it was the afternoon and I looked for the best places to eat, trying out a number of different things. By the time I got there, I was starving. And what better way to start off my trip than to go to my favorite biryani spot. This place is located a bit into the Gawalmandi food street. You may not have noticed it before, and they run out of the food by usually evening. So you have to go there around early morning or anytime before the evening basically, and once you go inside the food street, you have to take a left and it will be right in front of you after just walking a bit. The place is called the Lahore Biryani House, and they sell chicken biryani, which has the basic chicken in it which gets cooked with the rice itself, or additionally you can buy a steamed chicken leg piece to go with the biryani. One thing that I really like about this biryani is the fact that they just kept it simple, and that's something that I really like. And then when you add the steam piece and all of its flavors blend into the rice, that it just makes a really good experience. And all that for just the price of $2.40 is an absolute steal. The service is as good as you would expect in a place like this. You just tell them what you want at the counter and go sit in your seat, and they bring you over the food. The food is served with a raita, some salad, and they pour some spinach on your rice, which is cooked in a recipe that blends well with rice. And they also give you a shami tikki to go with your meal. You can ask for cola or any other fizzy drink that you want. The rice are well cooked and are in good quality. The steamed piece is soft, juicy, and the spinach is well cooked, and when you mix those things together, it's all really just like an explosion of flavors in your mouth, and trust me, it tastes even way better than it looks. The quantity is really good for the price, and all in all, you have a really good meal with different flavors and different things stacked upon each other that really, really work out together. And yeah, it's a steal for the price it is, and one of the best places to eat at in the Gawalmandi, which not many people may know about, so go ahead and try it out. Due to the fact it's the summer, obviously it meant I was getting deep fried the whole time, and in a time like this, you really need to drink something energetic and something that keeps you cold from inside and out, despite the scorching heat. And the sugarcane juice, locally known as the kanne ka ras, is one of the best things you can drink. It's a very simple process. They just put the sugarcane into the machine and it brings out the nectar of it. And then they just add some ice to the glass, maybe some salt if that's up to your taste, and some lemon. Also, based on your taste, if you don't want it, they don't add these things. It's as simple as that, and it's one of the chillest drinks to have in the heat. Another one of the things that you have to eat when you see them is Dahi Bhallay, which is one of the most common foods found on almost every block of the city, and I believe every other city of the country. The one I found in Gawalmandi was the Al-Mashur Lahori Dahi Bhallay and Cream Chaat, and I tried a plate of their basic Dahi Bhallay, and it was pretty alright and wasn't bad at all. And I've definitely had worse Dahi Bhallay, but if I'm being honest, it was not that good. So like, if you just want to give the thing a shot or just want to eat something, it's alright, and you even get a small little spot to sit in with a fan on top. But if you want to experience the real thing, the real taste, then this is not for you. One of the interesting things about the cool structure that you can see on top of the buildings is the fact that even though it's really old and kind of decayed, people still live in these places. You can see those clothes over there. Another one of the most common things about the food street that I've been seeing since childhood is the Meetha Pan, which is basically a normal pan, except for the fact that all the usual stuff that goes in it is not there at all, and all of the ingredients in the leaf are replaced with a lot of sweet stuff. And yeah, it's pretty good. I've been eating it since childhood and it's still as tasty as it was. Although it was slightly dry than I'm usually used to eating it from this exact same spot, but maybe it was just a one-time thing and it's still as good. So yeah, I mean, it was tasty, and if you ever come to this place, you should definitely give it a try. It's a fun little thing that's not going to cause any harm to anyone. Like the Meetha Pan, another staple of the food street that you have to try if you come here is the kheer that is served in those tiny disposable plates. It's really light, it's creamy, it's tasty. If you come here, you should try it, and I've been eating it since childhood and will keep eating it every single time that I visit this place. It's really good. Naturally, after walking so much again, I had to get myself refreshed one more time. On the opposite side of the biryani place that I showed you, if you keep walking there a bit, you will see this juice corner that I came across. From the looks of it, I wasn't expecting much, and the price was extremely low, which kind of made me worry about it because it was significantly lower than the usual price of fresh juices and milkshakes in the city. So I just ordered a milkshake and hoped for the best. Surprisingly, it was a very big mug and the shake was thick. None of the things were overdone, and that's surprising because usually they intentionally add so much ice that the ice is more prevalent than anything else, because they eventually have to give you less of the actual milkshake because there's so much ice in it, and that's something they also do with the sugarcane juice. But this was actually really well made, and for the price, it's an absolute steal. Now, every video should go out with a big bang, but unfortunately, that plan got botched. I was basically waiting to eat harissa from my favorite spot, which I have been going to since I was like maybe 6, 7, 8 years old, and I come here every year at least like 2 or 3 times to eat. But unfortunately, the guy that is at the shop on the afternoon time of the day is kind of, I don't know how to put it, let's just say strange. He doesn't really give you the food. Most of the times he denies you that it exists, and in the times that he's in the mood to give you the food, he just like tries to sell you off something that's like not fresh or something else. And this time his excuse was that they have mutton harissa, which they never make. They only make beef harissa, which has beef kebabs in it. And he said that we have no kebabs because this is a special harissa, so you should buy it, and we will not make the kebabs until the winter time of the year. Which was a complete lie because I go there a lot, so I obviously just said no and just accepted my fate. I did try to stay there until the night time. That's when the real stuff starts, like harissa, the fish. But my favorite fish spot was also closed for some reason, and even though I stayed there until like 7 p.m. where most places open up, the harissa guy, like the actual owner who brings the fresh harissa and the kebab, still did not come. So I couldn't waste more time there and just went back, because I had been walking around the place for like 3 to 4 or 5 hours, I'm not sure, but yeah, it was a long day. So yeah, that was a disappointing end to what I wanted to show you, which was one of my most favorite places to eat. But you can see how they start to set up the entire place. They block off the traffic, which you probably noticed was a lot earlier, and instead they set up those chairs and tables to sit on and eat outside. So like if the weather is particularly nice, you should definitely sit outside instead of any of the indoor environments. So maybe another day I will cover the harissa and my favorite fish from there. Otherwise I'll just cover more stuff like I usually do. So if you like this video, leave a comment, leave a like, subscribe and share it around, and let me know if you want to see anything particular, and I hope to see you next time.